So far, we've designed this basic 1-bit bimodal predictor and then a 2-bit bimodal predictor. And in both of these cases, I'm using about 10 bits of branch PC to come up with a number between 0 and 1023, which picks out an entry in this table. And each entry in the table, well, in this case, will have 2 bits telling me what the likely outcome is. Okay, so these 2 bits are trying to capture the common case in the recent past, right? So if it is 0, 1, then it means that more often than not, recently this branch was not taken. Okay, and if the number is say 1, 1, then in the recent past, the common case is that the branch is taken. Okay, so this is how I make a prediction. I look at the most significant bit, and that tells me which way the branch is likely to go. Okay, so now I'm going to try and build on this model some more. I'm going to build what is called a correlating predictor. And there are two kinds of correlating predictors. One is called a global predictor and one is called the local predictor. So let me focus on the global predictor in this video. Okay, so the global predictor is based on the insight that I will likely make better predictions if I have some good knowledge about what my neighboring branches are doing. Okay, so let's imagine this code sequence over here where I check to see if P is 0, then do something. And then later there's another branch statement which says if P times Q is 0, then do something. So in this case, there's a very strong correlation among these branches. If this branch goes along the then path, then this branch is also likely to go along the then path, right? Because if P is 0, then obviously this other condition will also be 0. Okay, so what the previous or surrounding or neighboring branches did is influencing this branch as well. Okay, so my claim is that I can improve my accuracy if I not only know my branch PC. So if I'm at this branch over here, I need to know its PC. And in the past, I've been looking at this PC and then indexing into a table and telling myself what the likely outcome is. But now I'm changing that a little bit. I'm saying that in addition to the branch PC, I need some more information. So if I also know what recent branches did. Okay, and let's say that all I need to track is what the last 4 branches have done. Okay, so if I have a 4-bit history that says the last 4 branches I encountered were taken, taken, not taken, taken. Okay, if I know this as well, maybe this improves my prediction. Okay, so now instead of just using the PC to index over here and identify the common case, I'm going to use branch PC and this recent history to index into this table, and this entry will now keep track of the common case for this particular input. So it says that for this branch and for this history, recently this branch has been more biased towards being taken than not taken. Okay, then likewise there will be another entry for that same branch PC, but with a different global history. So recently maybe those branches went 0, 1, 1, 0. For this particular pattern, right? So when I got to this branch and when the recent branches did this, I will generate a different index into the table, which might yield a different prediction, saying that when you see this pattern, the common case is that the branch will be taken. Okay, so if it's a 4-bit history, then a given branch PC will have 16 different entries on this table corresponding to each one of these commonly seen prior patterns. Okay, and maybe some of these patterns never show up, which means that there will really be no entry for that particular behavior. But out of the 16 possibilities, maybe 12 of them show up often enough that you have an entry for each of those 12 cases for this one given branch. There are 12 possible recent histories, and there's a separate entry for each of those. And each entry tells me what is the common outcome for the branch with this particular input. For this branch, for this recent history, what does this branch tend to do? And I'll make a prediction based on that recent history. Okay, so this is what a global predictor is. And let me just show it to you in more detail over here. So in this example, I have a table of 16,000 entries, right? Remember that previously I had 1K entries. And now for each branch, I want to allocate 16 different counters because I'm assuming a 4-bit history. Okay, so this global history could be a 4-bit history. I'm taking 10 bits from here. And I'm concatenating the two, so it's 10 bits of branch PC plus 4 bits of history, which yields a 14-bit number, and 14, 2 raised to 14 is 16K. So that generates a number between 0 and 16,383. And so that generates an index into this table, and each entry, like before, is going to keep track of the common case given this input. Okay, and there are all kinds of different ways for me to combine the branch PC and the global history. You know, in this case, I chose to concatenate the two. I could have also taken, you know, 14 bits of branch PC and XORed it with 14 bits of global history. Okay, and XOR is a great way of kind of increasing the information content within a given bit stream. Okay, if I concatenate it, you know, I basically have to take 10 plus 4, and that gives me 14 bits of information. If I take 14 bits of PC, I have, you know, more information. Likewise, if I have 14 bits of global history, I again have more information. And XORing it somehow increases my information content, because, you know, each of these bits does play a role in influencing that final 14-bit number. Okay, so I can use any kind of trick to generate my final 14-bit index, right? If I assume a table of 16K entries, I ultimately need a 14-bit index, and I can generate it in any kind of way. I can take, you know, I can take 14 bits from here, XOR 10 of those bits with 10 bits of global history, you know, and if I want, I can even concatenate a few more bits or whatever. So, you know, there are all kinds of different options before me, which allow me to finally generate a 14-bit index. And the two most common forms are to either concatenate the two fields or to XOR the two fields. And XOR certainly seems to be more popular because it increases the information content in that 14-bit index. Okay, so this explains the global predictor. And in the next video, I'll look at the local predictor.